This topic is the data encryption standard algorithm. This is the DES algorithm. Data encryption standard algorithm. It is the symmetric key block cipher algorithm published by the National Institute of Standards and Technology, NIST. Actually, DES is an implementation of the Feistel cipher. It is the implementation of the Feistel cipher. That means how the procedure followed in the Feistel cipher, same thing followed in the DES algorithm. It uses the 16 rounds Feistel structure. The total number of rounds are 16. The block size is 64 bit. Though the key length is 64 bit, the key what we are going to use, it's a key length is, even though it is the 64 bit, DES has an effective key length of 56 bits only. Since 8 bit of 64 bits of the key are not used by the encryption algorithm. Now, this is the DES algorithm, structure of the DES algorithm. So, this is the DES algorithm. This is the DES algorithm. It takes 64 bit plain text. So, bit block size is 64 bits. So, it takes the plain text block by block. Its size is 64 bit. Then using the 56 bit key, it encrypts the data and produces 64 bit ciphertext. So this is the decryption side. The DES reverse cipher algorithm, that means its encryption, its opposite algorithm, receives 64 bit cipher and 56 bit key. By using this decryption algorithm, it produces the 64-bit plain text. Now, this is the general structure of the DES algorithm. See the general structure. So, here 64-bit plain text is sent to the DES algorithm. The input of the DES algorithm is block by block of the plain text. So, its block size is 64-bit. So, the 64-bit block is entered into the DES algorithm. So, by using this initial permutations, these 64 bits are permuted and their positions will be reordered. After that, after the permutation, the output of the initial permutation is sent to the round one. Here, round one performs some operation on the 64 bit block which is received from the initial permutation, and by using this the round one uses the some key one which is generated by the round key generator. Actually, this round key generator receives the 56 bit cipher key, but this round key generator produces, among this 56, it produces 48 key. So this round one receives the 64 bit from the previous state, and using the 48 bits of the key, it performs some operation, and it performs substitution operations, transposition operations. So it produces some text, text. Then it will send to the round two. Round two also makes some of the operations by using the another key, which is generated by the round key generator, key two. In round two, the data is encrypted. Then round three, then round up till the data is encrypted in from round one to round 16. So 16 rounds the data is encrypted in 16 rounds, and finally the data from last round is entered to the final permutation. So the final permutation also performs some permutation and produces finally 64 bit plain text. So the main parts of the DES algorithm is initial permutation block, final permutation block, and 16 rounds. Each round performs some of the operations using the keys, different keys. At each round, it uses a different key. So this is the DS algorithm. So DS algorithm is a symmetric key block cipher algorithm. It follows the Feistel cipher structure. The plain text block size is 64 bits. Cipher text block size also 64 bit block size. Actually, master key size is 64 bit, but among that 64 bits are we use only 56 bits. Then it uses the 16 rounds, and finally, for each and every round, it uses the 48 key. From this 58 bits, it uses only 48 bits as the key for each and every round. This is the general structure. Now, what is the use of the initial frame? What does initial permutation? What is the functionality of the inverse initial permutation? Generally, initial permutation and its inverse are defined by the tables as shown in the table. These tables are to be interpreted as blocks. The input to the table consists of the 64 bits. Generally, here, this is the initial permutation. Assume this is the invitation, P box. So this P box is like this. So whatever it takes the input, 1 to 64 bits, then by changing the first bit is the first bit of the input is come as 40th bit at output. Then here this 58 bit of the input is coming as first bit in the output. Then here like this different. So here this is the table. This is the table which shows the permutations of these 64 bits. So what is its meaning? The 58th bit of the input is displayed at the first position. 58th bit of the input is produced at first position in the ciphertext. So the 58th bit of the input will be displayed, will be sent as the first bit in the output of this permutation box. Then 50th bit will be entered as the second bit position. This 42 bit entered as the third bit position, like this. So this it performs. This is the table which indicates the input bits which are permutated to the some other positions. So this is the initial permutation. So initial permutation and inverse, actually here one thing is, in the DS algorithm, initial permutation and inverse initial permutations have no cryptographic significance in DS. Actually, there is no use of these permutations, but they have implemented for future purposes. So the initial and final permutations are the straight permutation boxes, P boxes. These are nothing but some P boxes. So here it is the initial permutation. This table indicates the input and output position of the permutation, input bits and their output positions. This is the inverse initial permutation similarly. So this table, 40th bit, whatever it takes as the input, this will be go as the first bit in the output. 40th bit, that means this is the 40th bit. This 40th bit will be entered as first bit. Then 8th bit as this 8th bit as the second bit of the output. Like that. This 48, this 64. What is this 64? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. 64 will be send as the 7th bit in the output. So 64 will be sent as the 7th bit in the output, like this. So this is the inverse initial permutation. So here this is the initial permutation, this is the final permutation, inverse initial permutation. Now if you see the rounds, what will happen at each and every round? Generally, at each and every round, this is the round function. This is the round function. So as per the pistol structure, the block, whatever the round receives, the block is divided into two halves, left half and right half. So this is the left half of the block. This is the Ri minus is the right block of the block, right part of the block. So this right block 32. So actually 64 bits is the block size. It is divided into 32 and 32. So first 32 is the left block, then remaining 32 is the right block. So this right half 32 bits are first go to the expansion permutation box. So expansion permutation box, what is the use of the expansion permutation box? So actually expansion permutation box will receive some input values and produces more than its input values. For example, if it receives here, this expansion permutation box receives 32 bits, but it produces 48 bits output. So it receives the 32 bits as input, but outputs the 48 bits. That's why it is the expansion permutation box. Now, the 48 bits are the 48 bits of this right side half is come to the exclusive OR operation. Now, this is the key generation. This is the key generation part. So this key generation part also, if you see the key generation part, actually key is 56 bits size. So among these 56 bits in the key, it is divided into 28 bits and 28 bits. Now these 28 bits are left shifting, perform this some left shift operation. On this 28 bits, it performs some left shift operation. Then both are coming to here, permutation box, choice box. So this permutation box, actually it receives 28 plus 28, 56 bits, but it produces only 48 bits key. So this part produces only 48 bits key. So 48 bits key is entered to the exclusive OR operation. From here, it takes 48 bits of the right half of the block. So this right block of the half 48 bits, key value 48 bits, both are exclusive OR. Then it produces 48 bits. These 48 bits are again sent to the substitution box, S box. So this S box is, it has substituted the values. Similarly, it compresses the data into 32 bits. Actually, it takes 48 bits, but produces the 32 bits only. These 32 bits are again permutated and gives the 32 bits. Now, finally, the right half of this part is in the middle, it performs some of the operations on the right half, and on this data, this left side 32 bits and this right side 32 bits with some of the operations are exclusive OR, and send this 32 bits as right half of the next round. This is the 32 bits for next round. This is the round, assume this is the round R minus 1. This is the round, next round, R round. So what is the RI here? How we are getting RI? The RI, this is the next round. For this next round, the data is the left half of the previous round is exclusive OR with the right part of this data. By performing some of the functionality on this data with this key, okay, then this is exclusive OR with the left part. After that, it is sent as the right part of the next round. And here, the beginning of this right half is same thing, will go as left half of the next round, next half of the round. So here we have left part and right part for the next round. This is the similar thing. This is about to round. So every at each and every round, same functionality will be done. Only the key way will be changed. So this is the expansion permutation. So what is the expansion permutation? This expansion permutation takes the 32 bits but produces the 48 bits. So it expands the bits. Some of the bits are repeated as per this table. And this permutation function receives 32 bits and produces the same 32 bits by changing the bits. So same thing, what is done in this round will be performed in each and every round in the next stages. There are 16 rounds. So if you observe the round function, so assume this is the round function. How this function is working here. So see, round function, actually it takes the 32 bits from the right half of the block and it expands. This expansion P box converts this 32 into 48 bits, and by taking some key exclusive or this 48 with the key 48, then these 48 bits are sent to the S box. This compresses the 48 bits into 32 bits. Again, it goes to the P box. This is the round function. What I explained here, this is the round function in detail. Now, if you observe the expansion function of the round function, if you observe the expansion function of the expansion permutation box of the round function, this one, how this expands, how this box converts 32 bits into 48 bits. So this is the thing. So this P box is generally it receives the 32 bits. Those 32 bits are actually divided into some 8 parts for each 4 bits. So 32 bits are divided into 8 parts. So 4 bits. Each block contains 4 bits. This is the first 4, next 4, next 4. Like that, there are 32 bit input. So it receives 32 bit input. And this box produces the 6. So each one takes the 4 bits but produces the 6 bits as outputs. Like that, so everything receives the 4 bits but produces the 6 bits. Like this, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. So 8, 6 are 48. Like that, this will be generating 48 bits. So how it generates 48 bits? See this here. For example, if you consider this thing, these are the 4 input bits. These 4 input bits are come as it is here. But here, this bit position here, it takes the previous bit from the last bit from the it takes the last bit from the previous block to here. To here, this is the 6th position of this block. To here, it takes the first bit from the next block. Similarly, every part also doing like that. So here, there are 4 bits input. These 4 bits coming to the output as it is. But here it takes the last bit of the previous block. Here it takes the first bit of the previous block. Like that, at every block it is doing like this. But here for the bit position, it takes the bit from the takes bit from 30th position, from here. From here, it goes to here. And so this is the way of, so it takes each and everything, receives the 4 bits, but produces the 6 bits, totally 48 bits. So this is the expansion permutation box. So how the same thing is, the bit first position, this second position, third position, fifth position, so the same thing is represented in this table. Now, exclusive OR operator. What is the exclusive operation performs? After the expansion permutation, DES does the exclusive OR operation on the expanded write section and the round key. The round key is used only in this operation. Now, after that, after the exclusive OR operation, that is sent to the substitution boxes. See this. After the exclusive OR operation, after the exclusive OR operation, those 48 bits are sent to the S boxes. So how many S boxes are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8 S boxes are there. So totally these 48 bits are enter into the 8 S boxes. So these 8 S boxes are converted 48 bits into 32 bits. So here each S box, so here 48 bits are received by the 8 S boxes. Now the output of these 8 S boxes is the 32 bits. So see here. So each S box receives 6 bits, 6 bits from this 48. So 6 here, next 6 here, next 6, next 6, like that. All the 48 is divided into 6 parts. So each block is entered into the each S box. Now this S box is 6 input but produces the 4 output. So each S box produces 4 outputs. So since there are 8 S boxes, 8 into 4, there are 32 bit output. How the S box produces the 6 bits, converts 6 bits into 4 bits. For that purpose, see this one. So it actually takes the 6 bits as the input, bit 1, bit 2, bit 3, like that. It takes 6 bits as the input. Among these 6 bits, the first bit and last bit as noted as row numbers 0, 1, 2, 3. Since by using these 2 bits, how many combinations will be there? 0, 0, then 0, 1. By using 2 bits, we can produce these 4 combinations. So 0, its value is 0, it is 1, it is 2, it is 3. So the first bit and sixth bit of the input is represented as the row numbers 0, 1, 2, 3. Then the middle 4 bits are coming as the columns. So by using these 4 bits, combination of the 4 bits, how many decimal values will be displayed? 0, 0. By using the combination of 4 bits means 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 0, 1. Like this, there will be 0 to 15. 0 to 15. So these 0 to 15 is taken as the column values. Now, by using this, there are these S boxes, each and every S box, there are 8 S boxes. 8 S boxes are having the values like this. For example, 14, S1. Yes, so this is the table of the first S box. This is the table of second S box. For example, this 14 indicates, the, in this, 0, the value at 0, this 0, 0 is 14. So here the next value is 4. The next value like this. From using these table values, each S box uses the, it takes any one value. based on the table position. For example, what is the value at 315? So it will substitute the value, it takes the value from that table, and using that table, that is the 4-bit value, so it produces the 4-bit. So it takes 6 bits and produces the 4 bits. So the 32-bit output from the 8 S boxes is then permuted, so that the next round of the output from each S box immediately affects as many others as possible. So straight permutation. Then next is the permutation. So using this this table values, it permutates the values. This is the so this is straight P box in the round function. So it is doing, it takes 32 bits and after some performs some permutation using that table and produces this one. Now how the key is generated, actually how the 48 key will be generated from 64-bit key, then 56, then it finally 48-bit, how the key is generated. See this one, actually the key size is 64 bits, so the parity drop box is dropping some parity bits, 8 parity bits, and produces only 56 bits. So it takes 64 bits key but gives only 56 bit keys. Then these 56 are divided into 28 bits and 28 bits left and right. So here it performs some shift operation, here also it performs shift operation on the 28 bits, here also on 28 bits performs shift operation. These after the left shift left operation, these 28 bit options come to here, these 28 bits are coming to here, coming to the compression P box. This compression P box receives 56 bits but produces only 48 bits. So this is the next part, this is the next step to generate the key to next key. This is also perform the same thing. So here the shift left operation, for every shift operation for rounds 1, 2, 9 and 16, it performs the only 1 bit left shift. But for others, it performs the 2 bits left shift operation. So this is the key generation. So how is the decryption algorithm works in the DS? So as with any PSTL cipher, decryption uses the same algorithm as encryption, except that the application of the subkeys is reverse, key values are reverse. The decryption also same as to the encryption algorithm in the DA standard. Now analysis of the DA standard, this is the desired properties of the block cipher are the avalanche effect and the completeness. So there are two desired properties, one is the avalanche effect and the completeness effect. Avalanche effect means a small change in the plain, even though a small change in the plain text results in the very great change in the ciphertext, very great change in the ciphertext. See, for example, see this one, assume this is the plain text with all the zeros, its equivalent ciphertext is 1. Suppose if you change only single bit in the plain text, if this one only, this becomes 1. By changing this only small change in the plain text, we got the ciphertext is like this. So entirely different ciphertext. By changing single bit, we got the entire different ciphertext. That is the type of a small change in the plain text results in the very great change in the ciphertext. That is called avalanche effect. Completeness effect means completeness effect means that each bit of the ciphertext needs needs to depends on many bits of the plain text. So many bits on the plain text, that is the completeness. So completeness effect means that each bit of the ciphertext needs to depends on many bits on the plain text. The diffusion and confusion produced by P boxes and S boxes in DS shows a very strong completeness effect. Next, DS weakness. So weakness in the DS algorithm is, actually in the DS algorithm we perform initial and final permutations, but these are not necessary. There is no security, benefit by performing this one. In the expansion permutation, the first and fourth bits of every 4-bit series are repeated. That is one of the weakness. Weakness in cipher key. DS key size is only 56 bit size. Key size is 56 only. To do brute force attack on a given ciphertext block, adversary needs to check 256 keys. Suppose if I wanted to try different combinations of the keys using the 56 bit size, then maximum I have to perform 256 combinations of keys, that by using the brute force methodology. Actually, in the previous days it is not possible to perform 256 trials, but nowadays with the available technology it is possible to check 1 million keys per second. That's why we can easily break this algorithm. We can easily find out the key of the DS algorithm because its key size is 56 bits only. For that purpose, to make more security, DS algorithm is extended as double DS algorithm. Double DS algorithm means it uses 56 into 2 times DS algorithm is performed here. 2 times DS algorithm performed means it uses the 2 keys with 256 bits. That means 56 into 2 is equal to 112 bit size. So here the key bit size is 112 bits, not 56. That's why it is more secure. So double DS means first it performs the encryption 2 times. It performs the DS algorithm 2 times. For example, first take the 64 plain text, perform the DS cipher using some K1 key, first key, and produces some middle text. This is 64 bit middle text. Again, on this, performs the DS algorithm with the second key. So, on the 64 bit, on the first 64 bit, I perform the DS algorithm with the K1. With that output, I have again performed the DS algorithm by using the K2. Similar process will be done at the decryption side. That's why since it uses the 2 keys, it is more secure. We also use the triple DS algorithm. Triple DS algorithm means we are using 3 keys here. 3 keys. So triple DS was developed in 1919 by IBM, by the team developed by something. DS prevents a meet-in, the DS prevents meet-in middle attack. 3DS, triple DS has the 168 bit key. That's why it is more secure. So 3DS, triple DS with the 2 keys. Generally, triple DS with the 2 keys can be used. With the 3 keys also, it can be used. It is the 3 times we are performing the DS algorithm. So here, first thing is on the first 60, on the block of the 64 bit size, performs the encryption using the K1. After them, that here it performs the decryption on this text using second key. Then again it performs the encryption on this output using the K3. So here it performs the 3 things. One is encryption. First time it performs the encryption. In the next level it performs the decryption. and on then next level it performs the encryption. So encryption, decryption, encryption using three keys. So since it uses the three keys, the security is more and more. This is the thing. How this ciphertext is coming? See this one. How to get the ciphertext? Ciphertext is nothing but encryption of the plain text with the key one. Then this is decrypted with the key two. Then the entire thing is encrypted with the key one. So here, if it uses the two keys, it performs the encryption, decryption, and encryption. Suppose if it uses the three keys, also it performs the encryption, then decryption, then encryption. So more security is there. So due to this design of the triple DS, and encrypt, decrypt, and encrypt process, it is possible to use 3T DS hardware implementation for single DS by setting K1, K2, K3 to the same value. Second variant of triple DS is identical to 3D DS, except that the second variant of this is except the K3. Instead of K3, it uses the K1 itself. That means it uses only two keys. Here, one variation is triple DS uses three keys, is one variation. Triple DS uses two keys is another variation. It uses another variation. So finally, triple DS systems are significantly more secure. Triple DES systems are significantly more secure than single DES, but these are clearly a much slower process than encryption using single DES, because we perform the 3x DES algorithm. That's why it is the process will be slower. So this is the DES algorithm. So what is the structure of the DES algorithm finally? First, it takes the 64 bits and performs some initial permutation. Then it performs some operations in 16 rounds with the 16 keys. So each key size is 48 bits. How these keys are generated, I explained there. After the 16 rounds, final permutation will be done and produces the 64 bits. So here, main thing is, what is the initial permutation? How it performs the operation at each and every round? What is the round function? What is the expansion box? What is the